Hello everyone, and welcome to the Microsoft Security Update Summary, where I will present a short synopsis of what was released today, June 11th, 2024. My name is Josh Daniel, and I'm a risk manager in the customer service and support organization here at Microsoft. I'm going to start this video with an overview of the release, and then I'll dive into a few of the vulnerabilities. Please note that the details of the vulnerabilities I'm covering in this video may change, and the authoritative location for information will always be the online content in the security update guide. Before I dig into today's release, I like to compare it to the previous 12 months to see how it stacks up. With that, this month we have 51 total vulnerabilities that are newly disclosed in today's release, and that's a little bit lower than our average of just over 75 and a half over the past 13 months. Next, we'll talk about scoring, where Microsoft uses the Common Vulnerability Scoring System, or CVSS. This is an industry standard methodology to score different vulnerabilities across different software and hardware services and products. It allows us to kind of compare different vulnerabilities on a nice even scale. This month, the highest scored vulnerability is 9.8 on that scale of that goes up to 10, and we've been averaging just around 9.5 over the past 13 months. As far as the average score across the release, all 51 of those vulnerabilities, the score comes out to 7.3, which is just a little bit below our average of 7.39. Next, we'll talk about remote code execution vulnerabilities. These are the type of vulnerabilities that typically provide the most risk. They would allow a threat actor to install malicious software or other nefarious deeds. This month, we have 18 remote code execution vulnerabilities in the release, and that's quite a bit lower than our average of just over 27 of these types of vulnerabilities for the past 13 months. There's one vulnerability that is publicly disclosed. We've been averaging just under one. And finally, there are no vulnerabilities that are known to be exploited at the time of release, and we've been averaging just around 1.5 for the past 13 months. Okay, let's dive into this release, the June release, and we'll, those of you familiar with this chart, put the Windows products towards the bottom, and then we move up into the chart into products that we don't necessarily service every single month. On the Windows side, we've been averaging between the high 30s and mid 40s, depending on the operating system. This month, we're a little bit lower than that, again, because our total count is a little bit lower, so that shouldn't be surprising that we're a little low on the Windows side. Windows usually has the largest number of vulnerabilities in any release, somewhere between 40 and 70% of that total. So if the total count is low, then the Windows products are also gonna be a little bit lower than average as well. As we move up the chart, we get into Microsoft Office, where there are four vulnerabilities that are mitigated with updates in today's release. Visual Studio has three vulnerabilities. Dynamics 365 has three vulnerabilities that are being resolved. We'll talk about one in just a few minutes. And Azure File Sync, as well as Azure Monitor Agent, have vulnerabilities with updates that require customer action, i.e. you need to install the update to protect yourself. Okay, so let's dive into some of these vulnerabilities from today's release. The first one I'll start with is CVE-2024-30080. This is a critical remote code execution vulnerability, privately disclosed with no known exploits out in the wild. This has a CVSS base score of 9.8, so almost at the high point of 10, right? So clearly elevated when we talk about risk. The attack vector is over the network. The attack complexity is low. No privileges are required, and no user interaction is required to leverage this vulnerability. There are no documented mitigations or workarounds for this vulnerability, but I will point out that a system is only vulnerable to this if the message queuing service is installed and running. So if the service is installed but it's not running, it's not vulnerable. So that's not quite a mitigation, but definitely something to point out, especially when we talk about no privileges required, no user interaction. That makes some folks ask, hey, is this wormable, right? Can this be spread across the internet with no actions required on a user perspective? And that's not quite the case here. Again, in order for it to be vulnerable, a server or a system would have to have that message queuing service enabled. One other thing I'll point out is that in order to exploit this vulnerability, an attacker would need to send a specially crafted packet to a message queuing service server. This could result in remote code execution on the server side. As far as the affected software, it's all versions of Windows that are in mainstream support, whether that's Windows 10 and 11 on the desktop side, or Server 2016, 2019, or Server 22 on the server side. Next, I'll talk to a vulnerability in Dynamics 365. This is CVE-2024-35249. This is an important remote code execution vulnerability. The attack vector is over the network. The attack complexity is low. Privileges required is low, and user interaction here is none. This comes out to a CVSS base score of 8.8 on that scale of 10. There are no documented mitigations or workarounds for this vulnerability. And as far as the privileges required, what that means in this case is that any authenticated attacker would be able to trigger this vulnerability. It does not require administrative or other elevated privileges. As far as affected software, it's Microsoft Dynamics 365 Business Central, and it's three different versions of that. It's 2023 Release Wave 1, 2023 Release Wave 2, and 2024 Release Wave 1. And the last vulnerability that I will talk to today is CVE-2024-30103. This is an important remote code execution vulnerability in Outlook. This has a CVSS base score of 8.8. The attack vector is over the network. The attack complexity is low. Low privileges are required, but user interaction is not required to leverage this vulnerability. There are no documented mitigations or workarounds for this vulnerability, but I'll point out a couple things here. One is that the preview pane is an attack vector with this, and in regards to privileges required, an attacker must be authenticated using valid Exchange user credentials. So no kind of admin credentials or anything, it's just typical Exchange user credentials. As far as how an attacker would be able to exploit this vulnerability, a threat actor who successfully exploited this could bypass the Outlook registry block lists and enable the creation of malicious DLL files. As far as the affected software, it's Outlook Long-Term Servicing Channel 2021, Outlook 2016, Office 2019, and 365 Apps Enterprise. If you are a Microsoft Premier or Unified Support customer, and you would like to attend the full briefing call where we cover more content and are available to answer questions, you can either work with your CSAM to sign you up, or you can sign yourself up in Services Hub. All right, that's all I have for you today. I want to thank you all for watching me and listening to me talk about vulnerabilities in Microsoft products and services and how you can protect yourself. And I will talk to you all next month. Thank you.